ABC Broadcasting, management, or its sponsors. You have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark on Florida Man Radio.
Do you swear to tell the truth? The whole truth? And nothing but the truth?
You want answers? You want answers!
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
Do not adjust your dials on the radio or wherever in the blue hell you're listening to right now. This is The Blueprint. Matt Morgan, not attorney Justin Clark, on You Have Power Radio on the one and only Florida Man Radio Network. What's going on, Central Florida? What's going on here in the studio?
Man, good morning.
Happy Thursday. It's Thursday, right?
It is
Thursday.
Man, that, whenever you have a holiday on a Monday, it kind of throws your week off a little bit.
It does, right? Then you feel like you have two Sundays. Yeah, you're 100% right.
That's true.
But did you guys have a good Memorial Day?
Yeah.
Good day off? Anything exciting?
So for once, I actually did have a day off. You know, we went to Lou Gardens, and we know that Memorial Day is more for remembrance and honoring. So we did do that, but then we also enjoyed the freedoms that we have here in this country.
That these Patriots busted their tail and made the ultimate sacrifice for us, right?
Something that not a lot of people can do. Or are willing to do.
Right.
100% right. I mean, you talk about paying the ultimate price to protect these freedoms we all have today, right? I think a lot of people, you know, from time to time, they get so wrapped up in the barbecues, mm-hmm. Having the parties and things of that nature, they really do forget a little bit about that along the way. Not everybody, but I was really happy to see you here in Longwood. You know, those listening right now, this is The Blueprint, Matt Morgan. Longwood City Mayor and former WWE superstar, former American Gladiator. That takes forever to say. It seriously is. It's almost obnoxious.
Is it?
It really is. It's like saying the alphabet, like before and after your name every damn time. It's really annoying. But got to get it all out there because we want to come across as many demographics as possible to relate to as many people as possible, mm-hmm. because nothing is off limits on this show. My life is an open book. And I do like having back and forth banter with everybody about just about everything.
Now, question for you.
Oh, right off the bat.
No. Well,
how tall were you in eighth grade?
No. Well, we'll get to that a little bit. So we were like kind of waiting for you out in the lobby. And we were noticing, you know, vehicles coming by. And I'm like, do you think he would be in that vehicle? So there was a small, like, orange Scion XB with, like, rims.
Yeah.
And I'm like, there is no way in hell that he would even be able to fit in such a small vehicle.
Yeah.
Now, you don't have to let us know, like, your car, but do you have a truck? Do you have a minivan?
Truck.
Okay.
Always been a pickup truck guy. Yeah, for sure. Look, it's either that or the bulldozer, right?
Right.
Yeah.
You're 7 feet tall, you're kind of screwed in what you can fit in.
What's literally, I mean, he was like, do you think he's going to be in that little thing? I was like, he can't fit in that little thing.
With that said, though, you've seen Shaq. Shaq had a smart car.
Stop.
I swear, I'm sure he got it for free, and I'm sure it was like some sort of, you know, promotion gimmick.
I bet he only drives it. That one time. He parked it. He's like, that's it.
For that one photo.
Right. He's like, whew, that was tough. I'm not going to.
It really is. I just want to remind listeners at home that are listening to this, or actually wherever you're listening to it from, because here at Florida Man Radio, you can listen to this litany of different ways. It's 660 AM, 105.5 FM, but also online at floridamanradio.com. Mm-hmm. You can also download us at the Florida Man Radio app, which is what I do. I generally listen to attorney Justin Clark's I Have Power Radio show that you're listening to right now with The Blueprint. I want to make that abundantly clear.
Right.
I listen to that on the phone when I plug it into my stereo, into my car radio. And I generally listen to it from the Florida Man Radio app. Go on your app store, download it, and you basically take us anywhere. Those of you that are still listening, you can call or text in at 321-339-1055. We encourage you all to please include your name in the text message. And we're only going to see a phone number that it's coming from. So, again, you can ask questions via text message, to my understanding. And whatever you all want to chat about, we will do just that.
Mm-hmm.
And we appreciate you all being with us this morning. Hope my good friend, attorney Justin Clark, is having a very good vacation.
Right. Some R&R for Justin.
Guy works very, very hard.
He does.
So got some topics here in front of me, some ideas to talk about on the air, and we'll get to them. One of the things I wanted to see if any of you guys watched was The Last Dance, the Chicago Bulls. Did you get a chance to see that on ESPN?
I did not get a chance to see that.
You guys are missing out. This was amazing. This was so well done. And Michael Jordan was like my idol growing up as a little boy.
Yeah.
Him and Hulk Hogan. Very two different extremes, but they were as a little, you know, 6-7-year-old boy. I love them.
Love it.
So The Last Dance on ESPN was insanely well done because they followed, it was this documentary that they did, a 10-part series. And when COVID-19 hit, they actually decided to release it earlier because everyone was at home with there was no entertainment at the time.
Well, we had Tiger King.
Which we all went through in 2 days, I'm sure, literally like I did.
Binge the hell out of that. Next.
Yeah, seriously, that was done for me in our house in 2 days.
By Tuesday, I hated Carol Baskin with a passion. Blamed all the world's problems on Carol.
Now, going on with The Last Dance,
yeah.
Do you think... You played basketball.
Yeah.
I assume.
College basketball at Monmouth and then Chaminade University.
And not just because you're 7 feet, but do you think you'd be able to, like, let's say we had Jordan or Dennis Rodman and any of those players and they want to do, I don't want to say one-on-one, but maybe, like, you think you could dunk on them or they could dunk on you? You think you'd be able to?
They definitely could not dunk on me. I'd put them through the wall.
All right.
But if you notice what I said, I didn't say I was going to jump with them or try to block their shot. I'm just talking about form tackling them in the middle of the wall and spearing them and integrating my professional wrestling experience.
And that's it.
There you go.
I mean, there's not a lot of 7-foot athletes out in the world. You know, we have Shaq, we have Yao Ming, and you. So there's really not a lot of people that even like get. When did you start getting so tall?
You know what's crazy? And I just found this out, actually. I'm the country's tallest mayor.
Really?
Uh-huh. What?
And there's some high. There's some close ones. There's Glenn Jacobs, a good friend of mine who played Kane in WWE.
That's right. Yeah, he's a
future Hall of Famer for sure.
Oh, Kane.
So Kane is like right there. He's like a half inch off, I want to say, maybe 6'10 and a half.
Madness.
I believe there's another councilman somewhere in New York, I want to say. I think he's like 6'11 and a half.
That's.
But to my understanding, I'm the tallest, but I don't know.
Who know that Florida Man Radio would have the America's tallest man sitting here?
Right, just sitting in here next to some of America's shortest people.
Yeah.
God, my 3'5". I'm just like, well.
But going back to The Last Dance, I didn't see all the episodes, but what I do like about it is also like behind the scenes stuff that you don't get to see. Because I mean, at the end of the day, even though they are like super rich and wealthy, they're still human beings at the end of the day. And they still go through the same things that we do. They still cry like we do. They still bleed like we do. They still feel pain, sorrow, emotion, happiness, all that just like we do.
100%. Jordan was my guy. I was just telling Brianna earlier that was my guy growing up as a little boy and as my idol. And to see, you always knew how competitive he was. You always heard these tales and stories that he would play you in tiddlywinks until he beats you. It doesn't matter what the game is, he's not stopping until he wins. And I was able to see that as such a small kid. And between that and my father and how he brought me up, like between what work ethic was all about, I learned that at such an early age. Between that and having good examples, another one that helped me with work ethic, and this is going to sound crazy because I was so young. I was kicked out of 4 grammar schools before first grade, and nobody knew what was wrong with me. They assumed I had behavioral problems because I would act up. And we're talking right before first grade, so like most kids are acting
up.
Yeah,
you're a kid.
Right?
A big kid.
So I, long story short, my mom, you know, was like, look, every time something would happen, she's like, nothing's wrong with my son. Something's wrong with your school, right? Like, she was the ultimate defender of her little boy. And she was going through where I'm from in Connecticut, the Connecticut Post or the Bridgeport Post, I think, at the time. And Yale University was doing a study, a free study, on what was then going to be called attention deficit disorder. Mm. And this was back in 1983. ADD was not prevalent just yet. And they were testing a new drug out called Ritalin. It was brand new, to my understanding, and they were doing experimental studies on this stuff at Yale for free. So my mom's like, well, it can't hurt to try this. We got to figure out what's wrong with Matthew. And because it's not behavioral, there's something else that's off here. And brought me into Yale. I stayed there for a week. They had all these, like, these brain things that they put on mm-hmm. you to test your different levels. But more importantly, they also put like this heart harness on me that would be able to predict when I would become, whether my heart rate would go up and I'd get excited, and be able to almost predict when I would become impulsive.
Oh, wow.
Whoa.
It was pretty cool. And this is back in 1983, 84. That's crazy. And long story short, after the week there, it was determined I had ADD. And then we had to look for a special education school mm-hmm. out of the district. It was still a public school. I had a short bus come pick me up, bring me to school every day from first to fifth grade. I was in this special education class, and I was grouped with kids of all different shapes, sizes, makes, and models mm-hmm. of special needs, physically as well, you know? So I had kids on my bus that were in a wheelchair. I had kids on my bus that had a different mental incapacities or whatever have you, different special needs. They weren't just like myself. Right. And long story short, I learned about getting back to work ethic. I was basically in a room with a cubicle from the floor to the ground, and I couldn't look around, get distracted, anything like that. I had to concentrate on my work, or that was it. And then one-on-one with my teacher in between all of that. And I wanted to do whatever the heck it took to get out of that class and get back into mainstream with my friends. It took 5 years to do it.
Wow.
But from every day from first grade on, I just, my dad, between that, seeing like a Michael Jordan as an idol, how hard that this guy was going to be working, mm-hmm. Probably around fourth grade by then, I would say fifth grade by then. I learned a lot about if I put a work, so much work into something, I'm going to see the benefit from it. I'm going to see the glory from on the other side of this as long as I bust my tail at this. So that really became my whole thing in life. That I learned at such an early age that kids are not very fortunate, usually not fortunate enough to be able to discover. Mm-hmm. If I bust my tail at something, only good things are going to happen eventually, you know? So I used that into my entire later on in life story, becoming a professional wrestler, being the first person in my city of Fairfield, Connecticut to sign a national letter of intent to play Division I basketball on scholarship. Being the first in my family to graduate college. All these different things, it all comes back from one, you know? Common denominator, work ethic. I will outwork anybody in any room I walk into, and I'm competitive about that, you know, but it's just so crazy that I picked up on that and learned it firsthand.
Oh, yeah.
With growing up in special education.
Right.
So if I take a let's say a 50-pound dumbbell right now, and I do it 10 times, that means you're going to take a 80-pound dumbbell and do it 12 times?
Oh, my God, yes, yes, yes. Sadly enough, I won't even pretend I won't, yes.
I won't even pretend I won't.
What about a 40-yard dash? How fast is that?
It's like what I was just making fun of Jordan a minute ago for. I'm the same way. Yeah. Like ping pong, pool, you name it. I'm going to try to compete with you.
40-yard dash is two steps for this guy. Have you seen his leg? Yeah. We're like walking down the hallway, and my feet are like tick, 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 well, tick, trying to keep up with this guy.
Justin, he wanted to try and arm wrestle you, but we kind of told him, you know, maybe that's not a good idea, but he wanted to, but then he decided to go on vacation, so it's like,
Now Lurks has to arm wrestle you.
Do you think Justin could even reach my hand?
I don't think I could reach.
Justin would be doing this. Folks, you can't see what I'm doing, but I'm making a fist on the table and putting my elbow on the table. That's what Justin would be doing.
I don't even think Justin and I together pulling like one of your arms would be even a.
The fact that his fist is the size of my face is like absolutely ridiculous. And I looked it up too. Matt, mm-hmm. Kane is, he's also a mayor.
Yes.
Yeah, he is.
Oh, like, yeah. Knox County.
What y'all out here doing?
So he's in Knox County. So like, that's the equivalent of like, let's say, Jay Zembauer, who's a Seminole County chairman right now, or, you know, or Orange County. Mayor.
Right.
That's a big deal.
Yeah.
He's doing great work. Glenn Jacobs, a.k.a. Kane. Good, very good friend of mine. It's honestly, I think there's a part of it that you're thick. I'm reversing my words here. You get thick skin from becoming, I'm being so sincere, for 13 years as a professional wrestler.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time I would say I was a heel, a.k.a. a villain.
Yeah. Okay.
And your job is to make people irate with you. To make the fans hate you, but love your opponent.
Yeah.
Right? So you can imagine leaving the show and having fans that don't realize it's sports entertainment and they take it a little too seriously.
Yeah. No,
throwing
yeah.
milkshakes at my truck as I'm leaving.
No
I've had
way.
Pop tires in the parking lot before. Which, just to be clear, for me in my head, I'm like, yes, this is great.
They love me.
Yeah, but the fact that they take it to that level, I mean.
Yeah.
I mean, that shows you're doing your job.
But I'm doing my
job. You're
doing
your job.
That's 100% was in my
literally,
head.
Literally, yeah.
And so well, that is extreme. He's correct. But still, in my head, I was like, yes, home run. I had a great night, that means.
They hate me.
They can't stand me.
I love it.
And therefore, they're going to love my opponent.
Absolutely.
Which is the job if you're a villain. So Glenn or Kane, same thing. Majority of his career, he was a heel as well. And I do think there's something to be said about having thick skin and being able to take people, even when people blame everything on, they blame me on the mayor 9 out of 10 times for everything.
Yeah.
But I think it works both ways. I think you can't just get the praise. You have to be able to take the bad with it as well. And you've got to let it bounce right off your skin and not permeate. You got to be able to keep it moving and staying positive and realize everybody has an opinion on everything and they may not see the whole picture. I know I as a just a normal Joe Q resident, that's how it was for me. You know?
Yeah, let's back up a little bit. I'm sorry.
Sure,
because I know you just related being a mayor to being a professional wrestler, and that is great. But I think everyone knows kind of the process for like how to be an actor or an actress. You know, like you just show up, you look pretty, someone's going to film you, it's going to be great. How does one become a wrestler?
That's a great question. When I was a little boy, I was like, as a little boy, you can't just show up to like the boys club and like, so how do you swing a steel chair against somebody in their head? How do you learn the figure four, basketball coach? Yeah, great question. For me, I'm just going to tell you how it was for me.
Okay.
I grew up a lifelong fan, like I said, since 6 years old, right? Idolizing a Hulk Hogan, idolizing Ric Flair, idolizing basketball for
the
Michael
greats.
Jordan. All-time greats. So I remember I used to tell my family, I'm going to do this one day. I'm going to be that guy, Hulk Hogan, pointing to the TV screen, you know? And my family was like, yeah, right, sure you will.
Yeah.
So over the years, you continue to watch, you continue to be entertained by it, right? But then what happens is you get to college, you still kind of watch it a little bit. But then once I graduated college, or actually I take that back, right after I graduated college, I moved back to Connecticut where I'm from. WWE headquarters is two towns over from where I live in Stamford, Connecticut.
Interesting.
So a guy that came in one night wrote for the WWE magazine and said, hey, did you ever think about wrestling before? I'm like, yeah. I just don't know how you get started. What do you do? And he's like, I'm going to bring you with me to WWE Titan Towers, a.k.a. WWE headquarters. And they have a gym there. Vince McMahon, the CEO, the owner, works out there every Friday night from 6 to 8. Come in there with me. I'm going to introduce you. So for the next 6 months, I go in every Friday night. No Vince McMahon. No Vince McMahon anytime. And I was getting really fed up with it.
Right. Other 6 months.
And I'm like, you know what? He's just not going to come, right?
Yeah.
My last time going, I'm walking into the men's room. Vince McMahon opens the door and slams, like, walks right into my chest at eye level.
And then he flew.
And goes like, yeah. he walks out and just boom, right into my chest. Looks up and he's like, holy, how tall are you, son? I'm like, 7 feet. He's like, good Lord, what do you weigh? At the time, I was 382 pounds.
Wow.
I had an upcoming tryout with the NFL at the time as an O-lineman, supposedly. Long story short, though, right from that moment on, I said to him, hey, it's an honor to meet you, sir. He's like, did you ever think about wrestling? And I was like, funny you should ask. I've been stalking you for the last 6 months. You just don't know it.
it's crossed my mind once or twice.
But I try to be Joe Cool, as hard as it was. I'm like, I have thought about it. How does one get started, sir? And he's like, well, I'm going to give you a couple people. He gave me a couple people's numbers that were very important in WWE, Jim Ross and a guy named by the name of Kevin Kelly. And Tom Pritchard. I took all three of their numbers, called all three, met two of them in person. They were impressed by my size and my basketball background would mean I'm athletic. So I'm just a big goof that can't walk in a straight line.
Flipping all over your legs.
Right.
And stuff.
So they're just potential and just the look alone, they're assuming. I was about to start, and then they're like, hold off, because we're about to start a reality show on MTV called WWF at the time. Now it's WWE / MTV. Yeah. Tough Enough.
That's right.
You just watched that.
That's really, that's right.
So it was awesome. So long story short, they told me to send an audition tape for that. I did, and I was like, thousands and thousands of people that tried out for it. I got picked out of one of 12 to go live in this house in California, where they tried to really ramp up the drama between the people living in the house.
Of course.
But the worst part is just getting beat up every day by WWE superstars trying to teach you how to wrestle. And so, long story short, again, remember, I was like 382 pounds at the time, and I tore my knee in the first quarter of the filming of the show. So they had to have me leave. I had to leave the show. which stunk, and I thought that was it. There was my dream. I had it. It's done.
Oh.
And I got a call a week later from Jim Ross saying, "How's your knee?" And I said, "It's going well. It's going good. You know, I had I didn't have to have big surgeries. I had to have it scoped, it turns out." He's like, "Well, we'd still like to sign you to a contract." So I got signed to a 3-year developmental contract at the time. And then they had me move down. I had to move me and my future wife at the time to Louisville, Kentucky, where they have like a minor league system set up. They taught me the craft. And from there, you know, I was called up less than a year later to SmackDown. And I'm in this main event picture with Brock Lesnar as my partner and whatnot.
It's official.
And I was just like, it was a whirlwind after that. It really was. And it was very fortunate to turn into a 13-year career.
Now, we do have a caller on the line. We have Ron wanting to talk to the 7-foot phenom. Ron, you're on.
Good morning.
What's happening, Ron?
Hey, not a whole lot. Just a little story. So I go to this little pizza place over here off 434 in Longwood near Rangeline Road. And I'm coming out of the place.
Jerry's.
See this dude? You know how you just drive along and kind of see people? Well, I see this dude pulling in, kind of looks and smiles.
What's happening, man?
Ron?
Hello?
Oh, no.
Looks like he's gone.
Ron's gone.
But, well,
I'm assuming he's met you.
I'm going to make the cheap plug. It was Jerry's Pizza he was talking about off of Range Line of 434.
Jerry's Pizza in Longwood.
Yes.
Yes.
But
what was it like? Because we all, like, you know, Brock Lesnar is as well, and he's a beast within his own own category. Like, how it was for you to be next to someone like him? Because, I mean, you're bigger than this guy, but we just know this guy is... Yeah,
he was a heavyweight champion at the time, and I was really excited because to be, you know, penciled into a storyline with the top dog, I was really, really excited about that, right? Nervous as well.
Oh, yeah, I can imagine.
But did the best I could with it. They also had me paired with Big Show, which I just made no sense whatsoever because this guy, 7'2" tall, why would you bring in your quote-unquote 7-foot giant and put him next immediately to somebody that's 7'2"? Like, that makes no sense.
They should have put you and me together. You know, maybe we would have made more sense.
Absolutely.
But I was excited to be there. I'm living out my childhood. Not many people get to say they lived out, like, legit their childhood dream. You know what I mean? Like, not many people say, I want to be, the first baseman in the New York Yankees. I want to be, I want to be that. And very, very fortunate. But it all came, again, from work ethic.
Right. You know? Well, looks like we are up for our first break. Did you want to lead us into the break?
You got it. You're all over it.
He said it's not Euler.
All right, you're listening to You Have Power Radio with Matt Morgan, not Justin Clark, and we will be back after this short break.
You are listening to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark. Florida Man Radio. The Shannon Burke Show.
Welcome to the Guzzle Barn. Pull up a saddle and guzzle down some liquor. We're all in this together. Welcome to the Guzzle House.
The Guzzle House?
The Shannon Burke Show. Afternoons from 3 to 7 on Florida Man Radio.
Some bit. Pile of monkey nuts, goddamn.
Are you a business owner? Well, first of all, thanks for listening. If you want to find new customers, we can help on Orlando's newest radio station, WDYZ Florida Man Radio, 105.5 FM, 660 AM. Your ad could be featured right here in the morning with Bubba the Love Sponge. Key placement 10 till noon in You Have Power Radio with Justin Clark. Noon till 3 with the Ed Till Show. Or in Prime PM Drive during the Shannon Burke Show. We can create a custom campaign based on your goals and budget. Drive store traffic, engage new clients, develop more leads, boost website activation, and get your cash registered to ring with new business. Radio gets results, and JVC Broadcasting is ready to help take your business to the next level. For more information on increasing your success, visit our website at floridamanradio.com and click on the Advertise tab. Drive store traffic, engage new clients, develop more leads, boost website activation, and get your cash registered to ring with new business. Let us help you grow your business.
Reach out today, unfiltered, unafraid. floridamanradio.com. Click on the Advertise tab. Do it now.
To make sure the air in your home is absolutely perfect, call Four Seasons Air Conditioning and Heating. We're offering $1,600 in rebates or enjoy payments as little as $116 a month on a new Lennox system. Call Four Seasons Air Conditioning and Heating, 407-295-9231. Conditions apply. See dealer for details. License number CAC056308.
Does your water have a smell? What is it? And how to get rid of it? Tune in this and every Saturday at 9 a.m. for Water Talk, brought to you by Carter Water. When it comes to water, there are lies, damn lies, and crazy stuff in it. Water Talk on Florida Man Radio, Saturdays at 9 a.m.
It's time to burn all those COVID calories, so get off your ass and check out Fit to Row in College Park, Orlando's premium indoor rowing studio. Open now. Lose weight, tone up, get fit with no contrast. Fit to Row has you covered. A full body workout that's easy on the joints. Go to fittorow.net now or call 407-325-4781. That's 407-325-4781. Stay tuned to Florida Man Radio for your chance to win a free month at Fit to Row.
Trail Saw and Mower is keeping you cutting all summer long. Come out June 5th and 6th for their summer extravaganza sale. Trail Saw and Mower is offering the lowest prices of the year on all steel, Gravely, Exmark, and Kubota equipment. Whether you need to upgrade your fleet or get new equipment for projects around the house, Trail Saw and Mower has the gear you need for projects of any size. Don't miss the massive summer sale with discounts on all major lines of equipment and free lunch. Trail Saw and Mower, located on Orange Blossom Trail just south of Lee Road, Orlando.
Porky's Original Barbecue, voted Central Florida's best. You'll love their barbecue. Pulled pork, beef brisket, chicken, and ribs direct from their smokers. And their world-famous banana pudding. Porky's Outdoor Patio is open for dining with plenty of space between tables. You can also get takeout from Porky's drive-thru, and delivery is available through DoorDash, ChowNow, and iCrave. Open Tuesday through Saturday, 11 a.m. till 7 p.m. Porky's Original Barbecue, located on Main Street in downtown Apopka. And at porkysapopka.com.
If you have legal questions during the COVID-19 crisis, Orlando Law Group can help. From family law to estate planning and beyond, call 407-512-4394 or visit us at orlandolawgroup.com.
Be sure to tune in to Simplifying Retirement with your host, David Blackston, every Saturday at 8 a.m. right here on Florida Man Radio. And remember, at Blackston Financial, there's more to retirement than just your money.
Stop paying high electric bills and upgrade the value of your home today with a solar power system from IQ Power Solar. It's never been easier. With no money down and financing options available, you'll be using the power of the sun to take back control of your power needs in no time. Get a free consultation and assessment of your home savings opportunities by calling IQ Power Solar today at 407-585-1018. Or to learn more, visit iqpowersolar.com.
Florida Man is everywhere.
Everywhere.
Everywhere. In the car, on your radio at 660 AM and 105.5 FM. In the office or working from home, we're streaming live at floridamanradio.com. Out and about? On a run? Listen live on the free Florida Man Radio app and on your Alexa device by saying play 105.5 Florida Man Radio. There's no reason to miss any of your favorites, like the Bubba the Love Sponge Show.
One thing that brings my life down to zero.
The show?
No, this picture.
Damn.
Oh, shut up. That's not you.
Oh, look, yep. There's a tattoo. My Tyler tattoo.
Jacked up.
And Hogan's in the back doing abs.
Can you take off your shirt now and we do a side-by-side of this?
You have Power Radio with Justin Clark, The Ed Till Show, or The Shannon Burke Show.
Dumbass. We know we were off the air, dumbass. We have people that listen online, but you wouldn't know what that means because you're 90 years old.
Florida Man Radio. Unfiltered. Unafraid. Get it how you need to. Now. Everywhere.
The average time a resume spends on an HR manager's desk is 7 seconds, and most of them are tossed aside. Now imagine if one of those resumes belonged to Yasmin, who was
living in a shelter, juggling 3 jobs. I had to be resilient. That's something that you can't teach.
Or if that resume was from someone who
worked 12-hour shifts at the recycling company with my dad, who's 72. That taught me a work ethic that I carry with me every day.
We rely so much on a resume, yet it could never tell the full story of someone.
Growing up where I did, a lot of things could have gotten in the way of my goals, but I learned to push through, and that's what I bring to work every day.
So maybe it's time we look beyond the resume and look to grads of life. Discover new ways to develop great talent that are so much more than what's on paper at gradsoflife.org. a public service announcement brought to you by Grads of Life and the Ad Council.
Wake up and text. Text and eat. Mm-mm. Text and catch the bus. Text and miss your stop.
Wait.
Text and be late to work.
Sorry, I'm late.
Text and work. Text and pretend to work. Text and act surprised when someone calls you out for not working.
Who, me?
Text and meet up with a friend you haven't seen in forever.
Hi.
Oh, hey.
Text and complain that they're on their phone the whole time. Text and listen to them complain that you're on your phone the whole time.
Ugh.
Text and whatever. But when you get behind the wheel, give your phone to a passenger. Put it in the glove box. Just don't text and drive. Visit StopTextsStopWrecks.org. A public service announcement brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Yes, folks, the best entrance music in pro wrestling history. The Blueprint. The most genetically jacked, athletically stacked mayor in the United States of America, along with Florida Mayor Matt Morgan. And do not adjust your dial. I've taken over. Justin is in my trunk somewhere being kidnapped, and I'm taking over his show, and yes, he's not coming back. Sorry about your luck, Justin. You're, and all jokes aside, you're listening to Florida Man Radio. You can check us out at 660 AM, 105.5 FM, or better yet, please download our app, Florida Man Radio app, on your app store. It's simple. You could take us anywhere. Again, like I said, I generally listen to Justin's show on right there in my truck. Just plug my phone in and I'm ready to go. Please call or text 321-339-1055. We encourage listeners to include your name in the text message because we only basically see a phone number that's coming in, and that is it. Very, very honored to be here. Very excited to be here. And so what do you guys got next?
Do you like when Justin's like, well, Justin,
I mean, come on, Justin. Well.
That's pretty good, actually.
That's just like him.
That's very spot on.
Actually, let me play something here. Maybe you might recognize.
Now at lockdown, I love you too, sweetie. At lockdown, I finally put the exclamation point at the end of that Hernandez sentence.
I still remember this. Almost word for word.
So with that behind me, it's about time the Blueprint gets back on that fast track of gaining his first ever TNA World Heavyweight Championship.
It's like a minute 20, so.
Yeah, that's good. He'll be here all day.
Yeah, that's good.
And since everyone is just basically handing out championship opportunities from Sting to Hulk and Bischoff to even the network, here's a sound piece of advice for all of you. The Blueprint needs to be number one at the very top of that list.
I'm skipping lines, folks. Skipping lines.
You see?
Habitual line cutter.
This waiting game for me, it's stale. It's over. I'm bored. I'm sick of waiting for my time to come.
That's a shout out to our writers, by the way.
Matt Morgan's time is now.
Yep. I've been telling the writers, I'm sick and tired of waiting for you to write me into this stuff.
Fans agree with you.
I'm going into business for myself on the air.
I'm going to take it.
All legit, all real.
But Scott, you were talking about this. Don't ever, ever confuse my respect as a sign of weakness. Because I promise you one thing, Steiner. There ain't a damn thing on this 7 foot, 330 pound frame that's weak.
I forgot about the end of that. That was a promo going into an upcoming pay-per-view versus Scott Steiner for the number one contendership, which I won.
Which is
what you won.
It's just crazy because, you know, even like me growing up, I would watch wrestling late 90s, early millennia, and here you are with these guys that were like pioneers in their own right during my era.
You know, you're right. Same with mine. You're 100% right. And at first, I'm not going to pretend I wasn't awestruck. Of course I was.
Oh, yeah.
First, I'll give you a really quick story if we have time with The Rock, Dwayne Johnson. I hadn't been called up to SmackDown yet. Okay. His dad was down in our minor league system working, Rocky Johnson Sr., who just recently passed away. God rest his soul, amazing man, great trainer and teacher. Well, his dad was working, Soul Man Rocky Johnson was working with me on my punching and how to throw the proper, you know, punch without really
knocking somebody out,
you know, breaking somebody's jaw every match. So, a long story short, listeners right now are like, wait, what? Wrestling isn't fully real.
It's not real.
What?
These aren't real punches.
Well, sports entertainment, folks. So long story short, I get called up. Whenever WWE would come to Louisville, like SmackDown or Monday Night Raw for their TV tapings, they would bring us, quote-unquote, minor leaguers up to view the show, but be backstage with the other wrestlers, pick their brains, learn from them. And sometimes we'd have a tryout match to see where we're at in our development. Well, I had one that night, and it's called a dark match. It means it's not on television, right before Raw started, and I was a nervous wreck. And I only had like 6 months of experience at this point. I didn't know anything just yet still. So Rock, I'm walking down the hallway, and here comes Rock walking on the opposite side. And this is like one time I was really, really nervous, you know, and really awestruck by a huge, huge star. Rock was the man at this point.
Oh,
he was just starting to get into his movies. He really was the coolest thing in wrestling for sure. So I walk up to him, immediately put my hand out, shake his hand, say, "What an honor to meet you, sir." And he's like, "Cut all that sir crap." He's like, "You're up here now." And he goes, "My dad speaks very highly of you."
Wow.
And I, right then and there, I'm not going to pretend I didn't. I got so lightheaded.
Fangirl cried.
Like, you got to be kidding me, in my head. Wait till I tell everybody at home this, you know?
Yeah.
And then he's like, "Where are you changing?" And I'm like, "In the main locker room over there." He goes, "Go get your stuff. Come in my locker room." So I bring my stuff into his locker room, and he's like, "All right, now come back here." I'm like, "Where?" He's like, "Because the only other place he could be talking about is like where the showers are." And I'm like, "What?" And he's like, just trust me. Come back here, kid." And so he's like, "So my dad tells me you're working on your punches. I'm going to help you with something right now." I'm like, "Okay." So he closes the shower curtain in front of us, right? We're in the hallway of that shower stall, if that makes sense. And he starts throwing these live round punches against the shower curtain. He goes, did you see the curtain move when I punched it?" And I said, "No." And he goes, that represents somebody's face or their body that you're hitting. You got to treat it like that." And I'm like, "Okay." So he's like, "You got to go home and you need to be practicing throwing punches against these shower curtains. Therefore, you could see if you're really laying it in and stiffing and potatoing somebody with a really live round by accident or not, because if the shower curtain moves, and that means you're throwing it way too hard, you know?" And it was a really, really cool lesson for me because, again, it's The Rock.
Dang.
So from that moment on, my punches got really good. And I went home, did what he said in my apartment, throwing, you know, live rounds against the shower curtain. And anytime I'd see it move, I knew I was going too hard and back off a little bit. And punches and kicks, as ridiculous as it sounds, are so important. And today's wrestling is a complete lost art. Nowadays in pro wrestling, guys are just concerned about hitting these huge high spots and doing a lot of really cool athletic moves. Don't get me wrong. But if you ever notice, they throw forearms now. They don't throw punches
because they
don't know how to throw them, unfortunately. It's a lost art.
Well, maybe you can go back and tell one of these young brother, bucks, if I had hey, to, listen.
If I had the time, I would. Hmm, I swear.
You got Miyagi'd by The Rock, man. That's put you on game.
I was so excited, though. I really, really was. But that was one of those, like, bigger than life moments for me.
Yeah, I would have been too. I'd have like, "You're just talking to me. I don't even know what you're saying. Like, your lips are moving and..."
Like he didn't have to do that. I wasn't even on the main roster yet.
No, but it just speaks volumes of what you said about hard work and like work ethic.
Right.
That you did enough for The Rock's father to be
to
like,
notice.
"Hey, there's this, you know, blueprint. Mm-hmm. I have the schematics here, Matt Morgan." And for him to pull you to the side and be like, let me show you something real quick. So, I mean, that just speaks volumes.
And it also speaks volumes. Another great lesson in this, honestly, was that I learned at a very early age in my career that's how you treat everybody.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the same people you see going up are the same people you see going down that ladder. And I watched it with the biggest star, in the history of our business, him and Hulk Hogan, right? If The Rock could do that for me, nobody knew who the hell I was just yet. You know what I mean? That's how you need to treat everybody. And I was really, really impressed by that, because if anybody could have an attitude and act a little holier than thou or stuck up or too cool for school to shake my hand, it would be someone at that level like The Rock. And just the complete opposite. So humble. Very humble man.
I can imagine at the time. But even, like you said, athleticism, I think that's at least with wrestling. We all know, like, now that, yeah, it's sports entertainment. Right. But at the end of the day, you still injure yourself. You injure yourself, and you have to have
21 concussions.
Wow. Ooh.
21. I mean, I've also, yeah, well, this is a very weird transition, but it's the truth. I 21 concussions, and I've donated my brain. So when I pass away, they will use my brain as research, like they've done with countless other NFL players and other wrestlers as well, because Sports Legacy Institute and other places of the such now do research on that. And it's important that we know about concussions. And now, because of that research, there is no more chair shots to the head, if you've noticed.
Before, yeah.
When that would come up in a match for me, because that was like the only way to get me down a lot of times, was chair shot to the head. And my argument always used to be, why would I just turn around and just take a shot to the head with a chair? Why would I not? Why, in real life, my reaction would be to get my hand up. It would not just be, duh, hit me with it, you know, and turn around and just take it. You know what I mean? And it was kind of like a ridiculous machismo, fake macho, I could take a chair shot to the head harder than anybody. You know, that just, this business at the time was breeding, and it was silly and it was stupid then. And I'm happy to see that they've come so far now with what we know about concussions.
Now, with those chair shots, did they kind of train in a way to, like, properly, I guess, if there was a proper way to hit somebody on top of the head with the chair, or just
it's fifth gear. It is what it is.
Wow.
So they've taken that out, which is obviously very smart. They do have wrestlers' best interests in mind physically, especially with their mental health as well nowadays. But back then, in their defense, they didn't know any of this stuff about concussions just
right,
yet.
Right, right.
Which leads me to the next transition. So concussions have been a very, very big deal to me. And in Longwood, you know, obviously you guys all know I'm the city mayor in Longwood. Lyman High School is our high school there. Great high school. Love Principal Rice. Love all those kids there. I go in there weekly, generally, give or take, to do either motivational speeches, all right, or talk about opioids. I'm a 14-year recovered opioid addict myself, which if we have time, we could talk about. And also about helping these kids map out their bigger-than-life, larger-than-life dreams that other friends are telling them are ridiculous and silly. You have no shot in hell of doing. Mm-hmm. Give it up. Mm-hmm. I go in there to counterpoint that and help these kids one-on-one, dead serious, map these goals out and how they're going to get to make these come true. And when I was doing that, I got very friendly with the football coach. He gives me a shout one day. He's like, hey, look, we're trying to raise money for anti-concussion helmets. A lot of other teams have them. We don't have it in our budget. You know, is there anything, you know, you think you could do to get the word out that we're trying to raise money for this? I just opened a GoFundMe for it, he said. I'm like, absolutely. So about 2 days later, I was like, I've got a better idea. I'm going to put on a wrestling event. We're not going to charge admission. I'm going to call in every favor I could to some of my wrestling friends that will come in and do it for free. We'll get free ring rental, the whole nine. Again, a lot of these wrestlers get paid anywhere from, $500 a match to up to, you know, maybe at this level, the independent level, I'd say, up to maybe $2,000 a match.
Oh, wow.
And I had like 20 of them come in and be willing to do it for free. And the deal was, we had a Ryder Park. It's our new beautiful $4.5 million, just gorgeous park in Longwood. If you guys have not checked that out listening, you have to come to Longwood.
I have not, but
check out Ryder Park. We have the best butterfly garden in America. I will argue against anybody's butterfly garden.
Or no one's going to argue. Down. Right, no one's arguing with you, man.
It's amazing. You guys have got to check it out. We have an amazing amphitheater. We put concerts on there now. We have a splash pad. We have a playground, obviously. It's insane. Ryder Park. It's R-E-I-T-E-R. Named after a longtime resident of our city. Long story short, though, I put on the wrestling event there, okay? And we didn't ask for, we didn't charge admission. Instead, I asked for suggestive donations. Because if you have somebody that wants to donate a ton of money and you cap them off at a $10 ticket, well, then that's all you're going to get from them, instead of somebody that may have wanted to donate more.
Yep.
Long story short, we ended up doing like $20,000. Got the varsity and JV covered with these, they're called flex helmets. And what they are is they give when these kids go head on head with these collisions. Mm-hmm. It gives. It's kind of like a crumple zone in a vehicle. If your car gets into an accident, you know how you look at your bumper? If somebody hits you at 5 miles an hour, it kind of pops in and pops out.
Right.
At least it should. That's how these helmets work. And so they do help these kids immensely reduce the risk of concussions. And so I was really proud of that and very excited about that. Because, and so was the coach, obviously, and so were the kids. Because the kids are seeing somebody that doesn't, I don't have jurisdiction over our schools as mayor. Seminole County School Board has jurisdiction over our schools. So for them to see somebody who gets nothing out of helping them, stepping up and helping them, it shows
going above and beyond.
It shows that people care about them.
Yeah.
At a time, I will argue it's more imperative than ever. If you're a real leader, what are you doing in grooming your future leaders of tomorrow? You know, you stay holed up in your office all day. Do you stay holed up in your home all day? What are you doing? What are you doing with our people, our kids of our leaders of tomorrow to set the tone for them and do it by example and then be there in front of them?
They should follow your example. Right. You're one-on-one when you have time, one-on-one with these kids, and I'm sure it's making an impact on them. The same way that The Rock went to you and just kind of, you know, gave you some wisdom, you're doing the same thing to them.
Yeah.
Now we do have Mr. Josh Anderson here on the line.
Josh Anderson, what's up?
Hi, Mr. Morgan. How are you doing?
My friend, how are you? How are you?
I'm doing well. I'm doing well. Big fan of the show. I was listening and I heard you on there. I had to call in and say hello.
Josh.
And say, hey, what's going on, guys?
Josh, tell the listeners at home who you are real quick, what you're about, who you are.
My name is Josh Anderson. I am running as a state Senate candidate for District 13, which is Orlando, Winter Park, Bithlow, Orange City, that type of area. And I want to continue to make our state awesome, make our state great, and keep our future as a positive, bright, and sustainable one in a nutshell.
Awesome. So Josh, were you listening to the radio and you're like, what in the world? Matt Morgan's doing the show today? What's going on?
I was listening and I'm like, and I'm listening to you talking about your WWE stuff and it's just, and I'm only paying half attention because I'm at work and I'm writing, doing some technical documents and I'm like and getting flashbacks to, I did pyro, for a few shows, out west. For WWE, more specifically, John Cena just lost a championship on a pay-per-view, and it was the day after out in Missouri. And I remember a lot of people don't realize this, but like all the techs and all the superstars and everything, they all go to the same catering restaurant and everything like that during the show. And I remember sitting down at a table and Triple H is sitting there. This is back in his heyday, and
that's awesome.
The Rock is there and all these people, and I'm just sitting down at a table with like these guys that I've been watching on TV since I've been growing up going, dude, I am getting to do fireworks, which is my dream, with these guys that I've idolized my entire life. This is awesome.
It doesn't get better. I felt the same way when I first got called up, brother. Same thing. Hey, Josh, why have you here? Because I think that's awesome you called in. Tell us real quick about, you know, everybody has a story, their why. Generally, they should have a why. If they don't have a why, they shouldn't be running for anything, obviously. But with that said, what's your why, Josh, in what you're doing and what you're running for and why?
Look, I 2 years ago now, actually I started this journey about 2 years ago. 2 years ago now, I had a kid. And I want my child to have the best possible future he can have, no matter where he lives, if he wants to choose when he's an adult to stay in Florida or go elsewhere. I want him to have the best possible future he could have. And I grew up and I was taught that the only way you get something done is by doing it yourself. So I am putting in the time, the effort, the sacrifice, making the phone calls, having nights where I don't go to bed until 2 a.m. To make sure that my son and subsequently everybody else gets that same experience and gets to have an amazing childhood. In adulthood.
This sounds
Bottom line is my generation's the first generation that is statistically worse off than our parents, and I do not want to continue that trend for my child. I want him to have the best foot forward.
This sounds eerily familiar. I'm being so sincere. This is the very same type of ideal what came to me when I became a dad. When I became a father, I literally retired in the delivery room. I called WWE from the delivery. Am I exaggerating?
Wow.
Because it took me and my wife 14 years to have children. Okay, we went through every IVF with ICSI you could think of, known to man. We did it like 6 or 7 times. It cost so much to do, and we were ready to give up. And, you know, by the grace of God, Jackson Morgan, my son, who's 6 today, was brought into our lives. And I was not planning on retiring. I really, really wasn't. And right. So I can relate to what Josh is talking about. It changes everything.
Yeah, in that moment.
That the switch goes off that, okay, check, I'm done. No more on the road 5 days a week of every, you know, month of every year. For 13, no more. I need to do something. And then from there, it snowballed. It snowballed a little bit into, all right, well, obviously every parent wants to, you know, have their thumbprint, if you will, on their child's future to some degree. Mm-hmm. Well, how can I do that? And that's what led into, you know, serving the public. And I could totally relate to that with Josh talking about his own, you know, experience being a new dad and whatnot. It changes your complete, it just changes everything, you know? I mean, really, for me to leave in the prime of my wrestling career, you know what I mean? Like, when you look at it on paper, I would have said you're crazy.
Yeah.
But it's that big of a deal, and how your vision changes and how you see and interpret everything now in the world just completely changes. So I get it, Josh. That's awesome. I think that's a very good, I mean, one reason, you know, could be, it depends, you know, who agrees with you, who doesn't, right? But by the same token, I think that everybody should have their why, and I think that is one hell of a why, you know, mm-hmm. you'd be doing it for your child.
Yeah, not to get on a soapbox, but, I mean, the partisans killing our nation.
I'm joking.
And so, no, partisans killing our nation, and ultimately we all want the same thing. Our approach is just slightly different. Because of many factors, including worldviews and all these other things. Mm-hmm. And look, I am an avid outdoorsman. I am an avid hiker. I am an avid scuba diver. And I want to make sure that we are good stewards, that I can take my kids scuba diving in the same places I've been.
Yeah.
You know, we all want to grow and be the most productive and have the biggest bank account we can and have the boats and all the fun stuff. And be able to get education, have it affordable. And I want that for not just my child, but every single person in Florida, both native as well as myself. I'm an implant, just like you.
Yeah.
I chose to live in Florida. I chose to live in Central Florida. And I have learned over the time some of the issues and how we actually have addressed a lot of the issues and how we need to continue to stay on top of them to where we can get to even a better place to where we are now.
I love it. I love it. I appreciate that, Josh. One more time, let everybody home know what the district is you're running for, how can they help out, whatever, vote for you, you name it. Go ahead.
Absolutely. I'm ready for my shameless plug. So again, I'm Josh Anderson. I am running for state senate for District 13. That is East Orlando, Winter Park, Bithlow, that type of area. If you want to help or find out more about me, go on to my website at joshforflorida.com. That's all spelled out, J-O-S-H-F-O-R, Florida, F-L-O-R-D-I-A.com. And there's links if you want to donate, if you want to send your support, if you have leads. By all means, no man's an island, and I need everybody's help as possible. We're going to keep Florida moving in the best direction it possibly can.
Especially, we appreciate it, Josh. I think that's awesome you called in, man. And like I said, it's probably crazy sitting here like, what in the world is Matt Morgan doing on this show?
I have you guys on the back. I build theme parks for a living, and I'm writing some technical narratives about some of the systems that we are approaching to send in to a client. I'm sitting there writing technical narratives, and all of a sudden in the background, I'm just hearing Matt Morgan just talking. I'm like, huh. Like, chew up a little bit.
Right. Who put this guy on the radio?
Thank you, Josh.
This guy doesn't sleep.
Tremendous. So, Justin's not going to have a job. Listen to me. Justin's not going to have a job by the time I'm done today. So
right.
I'm just going to throw that out there.
Thanks
for calling in, brother. I appreciate it.
I will gladly come over and do a co-hosting with you anytime, Matt.
All right, buddy. Have a great one and good luck.
Have a good one.
Love it.
Now we got Fish.
Okay. Fish?
Good morning, everyone.
What's up? Is it Fish?
Hey, well, first and first, I want to say Brianna and Lurch, you're doing a great job with Justin and I'm playing hooky.
Oh, I appreciate it. You appreciate that. Thank you.
Yeah.
And Mr. Morgan, sir, you are awesome mayor of Longwood. I live in Longwood. Been there about 5 years now, and I remember meeting you over at Colony's Irish Pub, and you were like one of the coolest guys. Plus, I grew up watching you. And I think it's awesome that you're the mayor. Thanks, you are, man. A man of God.
Yep.
And since you've been mayor, Longwood just seems a lot more lively.
I appreciate that. That's awesome. I'm looking at a photo here right now of you and I at Connolly's. Oh, my God. I see. Oh, my. I lost so much weight during that election. Seriously, I was out hustling. I didn't have time to eat. I was nonstop door knocking.
It gets
nonstop.
It gets the job done.
Well, nice to talk to you, Fish. I appreciate that. That was really cool of you to call in and say that. That's the type of stuff that motivates you even more. You know what I mean? I really do appreciate that. That was awesome, brother. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome, sir. And God bless you and your family.
Thank you.
God bless Florida Man Radio.
Right, you as well.
Thanks, Fish.
How cool was that?
Amazing. See?
Those are the things. I mean, so sincere when I say this. Those are the things that replace any kind of paycheck. I'm being so dead serious.
Yeah.
I mean, to be clear, as Longwood City Mayor, you get paid like 900 and change out of taxes per month.
Peanuts.
So when you hear things like that, okay, people are like, what are you doing, Matt? Matt, you're busy as hell. Like, you don't have time to be doing things like yeah, that's all you kidding me? 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, my attention is fully on doing this and trying to improve our city.
Yeah.
We are a small city in Longwood. We're small as in Seminole.
Mm-hmm.
We're getting closer and closer to 16,000 residents. But huge leaps and bounds as far as how we've been growing.
Mm-hmm.
Again, between Ryder Park, you know, Publix, we do have an LA Fitness we just opened, two Starbucks, Taco Bell. There's just so many different things, and we've done
Taco Bell.
Now you're talking my language.
Well, how about, and you know, we also, South Seminole Hospital, again, has done some more redeveloping. UPS have been gone more expansions, up to like $55 million between the two combined. Like, it's just, long was a place to be right now. And I'm not all responsible for that. We all are. Me and my fellow commissioners are.
Yeah.
And very, very proud of that. So I know we got to get to a break. So just want to say you're all listening to Florida Man Radio Network. This is The Blueprint. Matt Morgan filling in for, no, taking over for Justin,
right.
Attorney Justin Clark.
Permanently.
On You Have Power Radio. 660 AM, 105.5 FM, floridamanradio.com. We'll be right back.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with Attorney Justin Clark. Florida Man Radio.
Central Florida, Bill O'Reilly here. You deserve the truth and news with no spin. I don't care what side you're on. Catch me on Florida Man Radio, weekday mornings at 9:10 and 11:50 to give you the unfiltered and unafraid news updates. The O'Reilly Update right here on Florida Man Radio.
660 AM, 105.5 FM, streaming at floridamanradio.com.
Hey, it's Logan Sekulow. The Logan Sekulow Reprogram is Central Florida's hottest new daily radio show, airing Monday through Friday at 5 a.m. on Florida Man Radio. Wake up each morning to a brand new show covering our ridiculous lives, current events, interviews with incredible Americans, a weekly playlist featuring rock, metal, and real country music, a bit of politics thrown in there, and more. Join us for a daily celebration of our country and the freedoms that it provides, and we'll have some laughs along the way. If you miss real morning talk radio, this show is for you. The Logan Sekulow Reprogram.
Bellicoso Cigars and Cafe in Mills 50, a walk-in humidor with great selection of premium cigars, a rooftop terrace plus indoor smoke-free seating and a spacious outdoor patio, your favorite alcoholic beverages, and a new menu featuring empanadas, wings, Black Angus burgers, yuca fries, charcuterie plates, and our barbecue. Bellicoso Cigars and Cafe, open 3 till 10 Wednesday through Saturday on Mills Avenue, Orlando. Thursday, get 25% off Warped cigars and 15% off all other cigars.
Let's get America driving again, starting right here in Central Florida. With lowered prices at Holler Honda and Classic Honda in Orlando, now is the time to buy in our safe and sanitized showrooms. And during our Memorial Day sales event, we have some incredible limited-time incentives for everybody, and especially for healthcare workers and first responders, like $500 towards down payment of any new eligible Honda vehicle. Call us or visit us online to check out our best price first and low lease payments. And while our prices are at an all-time low, lease a 2020 Honda Civic LX sedan with automatic transmission for only $114 per month, or the 2020 Honda CR-V LX two-wheel drive with automatic transmission for $179 per month. Both vehicles lease for 36 months, 12,000 miles per year, $19.99 down, tax, tag, title, and a $799 dealer fee due at signing. Or finance either vehicle for 1.9% APR for 60 months and make no payments for 90 days. Both offers with approved credit. See dealer for details. Visit us online at hollerhonda.com and classichonda.com. Let's get back on the road, America.
We've all been stuck in our houses for a long time, but now that we can get out, it's time for your new look from Skip's Western Outfitters. During the huge Memorial Day blowout sale, you can save big money on boots and apparel for the whole family. Support local business. Skip's has been in the same location in downtown Osteen for 37 years, and Skip's has the world's largest indoor Western city in Daytona, across from the Speedway. Save on name brands like Ariat, Corral, Lou Casey, Durango, Harley-Davidson, Stetson, Wolverine, Wrangler, Miss Me, and more. Get up to 40% off select styles, plus many unadvertised specials. And if you're still at home, shop at skipsboots.com, where orders go out within 24 hours. The huge Memorial Day blowout sale. Boots, hats, apparel, you name it. Get to Skip's Western Outfitters on State Road 415 and Doyle Road, I-4 exit 108, just 7 miles east. Or the world's largest indoor Western city in the Best Buy Plaza across from the Speedway in Daytona. And at skipsboots.com. It's all about attitude and Skip's. It's
about. Start driving the truck that you deserve today. Ford, Chevy, Ram, and GMC. Nation's Trucks has got them all. And with approved credit, you won't make any payments for 120 days. Do yourself a favor. Before you buy any truck, new or used, visit nationstrucks.com right now.
Do you have a leaky roof? Are your shingles lifting or falling off? Well, stop what you're doing and give Mecca Roofing a call today. With years of experience and a highly trained staff, their goal is to provide the highest quality work while staying within your budget. So if you are ready for a superior roof, contact Mecca Roofing today at 407-330-2360. Again, that's 407-330-2360. Mecca Roofing means superior craftsmanship.
Adopt US Kids presents What to Expect When You're Expecting a Teenager. Learning the lingo.
Today I'm going to help parents translate teen slang. Now, when a teen says something is on fleek, it's exactly like saying, that's rad. It simply means that something is awesome or cool. Another one is totes. It's exactly like saying, totally, just shorter. As in, I totes love going to the mall with Becca. Another word you might hear is jelly. Jelly is a shorter, better way to say jealous, as in, Chloe, I am like so jelly of your unicorn phone case.
You don't have to speak teen to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will think you're, rad just the same. To learn more, visit AdoptUSKids.org. A public service announcement brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, AdoptUSKids, and the Ad Council.
Call me, Mark Anajar, at the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733 for a free consultation. And take back control of your life.
Office in Orlando.
Olivia, from Washington. Laid off and trying to keep our little kids from realizing that mommy and daddy haven't eaten in a while.
Roger, from California. I'm grateful we could afford our son's surgery. I'm nervous that now we can't really afford food.
Daniel from California, choosing whether to pay the rent or pay to fix the car to get to work doesn't leave us with much at all. Now we can't even pay for meals.
Donna from Louisiana, the storm just hit and we went from donating to the food bank to needing it.
Keisha from South Carolina, I've been skipping meals so my two kids can eat, but filling up on water doesn't really work.
Hunger is a story we can end. End it at feedingamerica.org. Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
I'm News 6 anchor Bridget Ellison. Here are your Thursday morning headlines. Disney and SeaWorld have revealed their plans for reopening to guests. While Disney World wants to reopen its parks over several days, starting July 11th with Magic Kingdom and Animal Kingdom, Disney says it will be pausing new ticket sales to focus on existing reservations. SeaWorld wants to open in a few weeks on June 11th. NASA and SpaceX will try again this weekend to launch a pair of astronauts on a mission to the International Space Station. The launch attempt yesterday was scrubbed with just minutes to go due to bad weather. They'll try again Saturday afternoon. A major milestone for a big construction project at Orlando International Airport. A topping off ceremony was held Wednesday at the new South Terminal. Officials say the multi-billion dollar project is now more than halfway complete, but it's being scaled back due to the pandemic. Get more updates on news, weather, and traffic around the clock on clickorlando.com and the News 6 app.
WDYC, Altamont Springs, W288CJ, Oviedo, a JVC broadcasting station, 660 AM, 105.5 FM, Florida Man Radio. Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
Some SmackDown Matt Morgan entrance theme there. Don't adjust your dials. Once again, this is not attorney Justin Clark. This is the blueprint, Matt Morgan, Longwood City Mayor Matt Morgan, here on 660 AM / 105.5 FM, Florida Man Radio Network. Very honored, very privileged to be here filling in for Justin while he's away in my trunk. while I take over his airwaves. I said it on Twitter. I was like, does he understand how dangerous this is to give me a live mic? I don't want to, you know, politicians get a bad rap, you know, not a bad rap, but I should say a certain stigma about them that everything that they say is very canned and whatnot. So I go into everything with zero, no prepared speeches, nothing. Even when I do go give speeches, it's all off the top of my head. It's all from my heart because you can't go wrong. And I think people have the best BS meter on the planet today more than ever. And I think it's refreshing, honestly, not just to sound like I pat myself on the back here. I don't mean it that way. I mean it in the manner of you can't go wrong. You know what I mean? If you don't know something, it's just simple. You simply say that. You just be honest with all your residents that you represent at all times. And I think that's what's been so far successful, that everybody in Longwood that pays attention to what's happening, and maybe they follow our city commission meetings on Facebook Live, which I'm very proud of that. I you know what? Before I get into something about my son real quick, I did want to bring that up. When I first got elected as Longwood City Commissioner in 2017, I went from commissioner to deputy mayor to mayor within this first term here. My term is up November 2020. With that said, right when I got elected, one of the things I really wanted to push for was, if I'm doing this job right that I just got elected to do, it's not about what Matt Morgan thinks is best. It's supposed to be what the people think is best that you're representing. Your job is to be their conduit. So I am literally their 7-foot, 300-pound conduit, their megaphone, their giant 7-foot megaphone, if you will. And I take that up onto the dais with me at every commission meeting. And the only way you can know what your folks that you represent want is you got to be in front of them. You got to be with them 24/7. You got to be, it's not just going out and glad handing, kissing babies, signing autographs, taking photos. Okay. You're supposed to be at these events, these different social gatherings that they have at our park, let's say, or being one with our police departments, our fire departments, and our residents at all times. So you know where they're at on issues. Yeah. So you take that up on the dais when you make the decisions on creating certain policies in the city of Longwood. And one of the things that I noticed when I was campaigning in 2017 was that nobody knew what the hell a city commissioner was. All right. What's a commissioner? That was the majority of the answers I got back. And to be fair, that's, I'll just be honest, that's like that in most cities, quite frankly.
Yeah.
You don't really know what a commissioner or mayor, you know what a mayor is, obviously, but you don't know what a commissioner does per se, because until you have a problem and then you need help, then you find that you figure that stuff out generally. So a long story short, my whole thing was, well, if I'm going to do this right and I'm going to represent the mass of the residents of Longwood and what they want in this city, I've got to constantly be in contact with them, not just in person, but they need to be able to see these meetings in which we're creating the policies that are going to be affecting them, because I want them to be a part of the decision-making process. So how do we do that? Well, I was very, very proud to introduce Facebook Live. We were the first city, to my understanding, in Southeast United States, quite frankly, to have their city commission meetings on air on Facebook Live.
Wow. That's awesome.
Previously, it was only you can listen to our city commission meetings afterward in person, all right, which would get like 16 people at the meetings, give or take, out of almost 16,000 residents. So that's a lot to be desired in making sure your residents know what's happening. All right. And then two, you could listen to it the next day on audio file on our city's website. Well, my whole thing, I said, that is so archaic. That is so behind the times. We need to be on as many platforms as possible, not just as a city. We didn't even have a Twitter account. We didn't have a Instagram account.
Yeah.
We just had Facebook and then a city website. And I was like, nobody goes into a search engine and presses and types rather you know, www.whatever.com. Nobody does that anymore. They go on their phone, they press the app right there, and then they go to whatever that is. Mm-hmm. And it's usually Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, now TikTok, so many different places. Now, to get the generally, what, that's where a lot of people get their news from, in their timelines. I said, as a City Longwood, I want to be in their timelines. I want to be in their feeds with what we're doing here in the city. They have to know, because it's previously, I would argue, it's like being a fallen tree in the forest. Does anybody really hear it? So if you're making amazing policy and nobody in your city knows about it, really, what's it, you know? So people need to be part of the decision-making process more. I thought it was smart that we'd go into open it up to our commission meetings, Facebook Live, where people could view the show live. But better yet, this is my favorite part. You get to go back and watch them in our archives. Mm-hmm. So you get to see which commissioner votes for what and which commissioner doesn't. You get to see what commissioners and mayors is passionate about, what they're not. And most importantly, things that might affect you, the Longwood resident, directly, you can go back in time now and see when that was decided and how it was decided. I think that is so darn important. Another part of that I wanted is that each commission meeting, we have two commission meetings a month, rather, and the way Longwood works is we're a team of five up there. We have three commissioners, a deputy mayor, and a mayor, but we all are technically five commissioners, and we all have the same power, quote-unquote, as one another do. The mayor does not have any more say in something than any other commissioner up on that dais. That's what makes us different than some other cities, for that matter. So I find it very important that every time we have a commission meeting, like, again, it's the first and third Mondays at 6 p.m. of every month for Longwood, is when we get to the commissioner's reports each commission meeting, that you put it out there what you've been doing since the last commission meeting as an elected official. That needs to be your resume. That needs to be, this is what I've been doing, because you guys, you all came out in droves to support me and put me in office because you all believed in me so darn much. Here's what I've been doing. And more importantly, it shows your residents that you're not just another one of these elected politicians that just takes it for granted and just sits back with their feet kicked up on a desk somewhere being Big Willie. You know what I mean? Yeah. And thinking they're cool, too cool for school. That you're out there and you're with your public nonstop. And I'm very proud of that, because, you know, people like to say I have OCD, you know, and whatnot. I'm everywhere. And I take that as a compliment, not an insult, because that's the job. How could you possibly know what your residents want, especially almost 16,000 residents? Wow. How?
That's a lot.
You have to be out there with them, and you have to engage with them on a multitude of different platforms. And that's why I'm very proud of the Longwood social media initiative that I helped start up. By, again, simply opening up Twitter, open up Instagram, increasing our Facebook traffic, and getting the news out to our public on what the great stuff that your city commission has been doing. Because otherwise, again, it's like that, again, I keep saying, the tree in the forest that falls. Does anybody really hear it? No. Same thing when you're creating policy in a city that you're not able to get the message out to. So very, very proud of that. While I have everyone here, some of the questions I know I've gotten is I'm getting coming in is about my son, Jackson. So those of you, you know, I said alluded to it a little bit earlier. When my son, Jackson Morgan, was born in 2014, it was January 7th, right? Went through 14 years trying to have a child, didn't work. Year 14, I would say, of now not trying, by the grace of God, my wife got pregnant. We both couldn't believe it. We prayed for it every day, and it came true. So here I am in the delivery room, right? I'm supposed to go back to WWE and re-debut, at upcoming huge pay-per-view called the Royal Rumble. I was going to be a surprise entrant into the Royal Rumble. And people would have lost their you-know-what about me coming back. It would have been awesome. It was like January 20-something I was due back. Mm-hmm. And my son just gets born, had emergency C-section. My wife did, rather, not me. Listen to me taking all the credit here. Son's now in my hands for the first time, and it was that switch goes off. That's it. I am done. No more on the road 5 days a week of every week of every month of every year. No more. Because I used to previously only see my wife on a Saturday, half of a Sunday, rinse and repeat, back out on tour again. And that's hard. And now imagine doing that as a dad. After begging God for 14 years for this gift, and here he is, and I'm just going to say, see, no way. So call WWE, let them know. I appreciate, you know, the opportunity to come back. called a prior company I wrestled for, TNA Impact Wrestling, thanked them as well, and said, you're going to probably hear some rumors that I'm retiring. It's not a rumor. I am really legit retiring. And I appreciate everything you've done for me and my family as well, to both companies. Mm-hmm. And then from that moment on, it was game on. What I'm never going to leave my son's side another day. No way. So, you know, like I said, your purview in life changes from that moment on. So I want everyone to keep that in mind. So it turned out to be an amazingly wise decision because right before my son turned 3, Jackson was diagnosed as being nonverbal autistic, moderate to severe on the ASD spectrum. Mm-hmm. Excuse me. So that definitely was the right decision. You know, you can't just have your wife do all the work at home and you're just not there. That's the way I felt about it, right? And it for sure. Definitely was the right move in the long run. So those of you, you know, that have autistic children, you know what I'm talking about. It is a lot of work, and it's God's work. It really is. As far as I feel blessed, actually, that's my son. I think, and not to sound holier than thou or arrogant, but I think, like I told my wife, you know, every once in a while, Larissa would, you know, struggle with it at first, as every parent would, mm-hmm. with, you know, why would God do this, you know?
Right.
And I'm like, are you kidding me? It's not why would he do this. It's holy bleep. He chose us.
Yeah.
He chose us.
Yeah.
He chose us because he believes in us. Mm-hmm. And he made us wait this long, 14 years and never have a child, because he believed in us this much to get to this point in our maturity levels and where we are in life, yeah. and whatever the heck, mm-hmm. that now's the time. I'm going to bless you with what you've been begging me for 14 years.
Yeah.
Because we think you got, I think, that you guys are the ones to do it.
Yeah, you don't have to do it. You get to do it.
Right.
Yeah.
And every day is I'm not exaggerating this. Every day with this little boy is a miracle because he was given like a 99.something% chance to never talk, something like that.
Yeah.
And, you know, folks, I encourage you to go on my Twitter or my Instagram, at BP Matt Morgan, and scroll down a little bit, and you'll see the video of me and my son working on the alphabet, swimming, or cutting with scissors, or with construction paper, you name it. And you just see my reaction. It's like,
yeah.
it's like legit winning the lotto every day with something new that he's able to do. And more importantly, prove those doctors wrong that he can say certain words and he is getting there and he isn't as nonverbal as they try to say he would be.
Yeah.
You know, it's I'm being so sincere when I say that it is literally like Christmas morning every day with him, because I'm able to see something new in his development and his improvement that just mind boggles me.
Yeah.
Like, he can go on your phone right now, I swear to you, and be able to scroll through and find whatever app you ask him to find. He plays video game. One day we were at this dentist. Listen to this. We were one day at this dentist that has a children's section. In Lake Mary, and they have like this little arcade area with iPad platforms, right? Mm-hmm. You can pick whatever video game you want. Jackson goes into this little booth that has it, picks this certain game, and starts going to town on it. Mind you, let me be clear. He's never played a video game in his life, ever. Wow. I called the school just to double check. he's never played a game, ever. He does not know what a game is, keep in mind. And he's going through Subway Surfer. That was the game. And he's going 100 miles an hour, running, jumping, clicking coins. And I tape this too, because my phone is always ready when it comes to him, because I'm not missing no moments with him. And I'm telling you, he is so darn smart, man. He really is so darn smart. And again, there's these constant jaw-dropping moments, mm-hmm. almost daily with his development, that again, I feel so blessed that God chose us to have this child. And so, so proud of him. So, so, so proud of him. He's 6 years old. And just again, he's my whole world. He's my whole life. He is beyond my why.
And it shows in your passion when you like speak about it as mm-hmm. well. You know, you're not just saying it just to say. You're saying it because you're truly passionate about like his well-being, the moments you have with him, and progressing through life with him.
And the other thing, the other part of this is, look, I grew up in special needs myself. I grew up special education myself. Mm-hmm. So I always knew when I'd be a parent one day. There'd be a high probability, I was thinking, that my child would have at least ADD. Who knows? And I work with special needs kids as well. They need to be able to see that light at the end of the tunnel. a lot of times. And I like being able to come in there and provide it and using my past as a pro wrestler on their TV screens or bringing in one of my action figures or 8x10, whatever, to get their attention and get them at the edge of their seats and then hit them with some truth and some really, really important conversations about them as well, following their goals and their dreams as well.
Right.
All right. Well, we do have a caller here. We have Sharon calling, wanting to ask you a question.
Hey, Sharon.
Hey, Matt, Brianna, and Lurch. Good morning.
Good morning, Sharon.
What a beautiful show. Perhaps I want to start with a comment, if I may.
Yeah.
You know, in my opinion, Justin's why could be setting up his show as though he was there. So that's great leadership. Brianna and Lurch is doing exactly what their why is. They are fantastic, even without him. So he has done a good job, and they have done a good job in even choosing you to host this segment of his show. My question is, Matt, do you think opioid could affect pregnancy in a negative way?
My personal opinion, I think it's sure. I think it could. I'm no doctor. Okay. I'm a 14-year recovered opioid addict. But to tell a little backstory on our personal situation, my wife by herself, no Matt Morgan at all, just she by herself, was told she would never be able to be a mother. Me, by myself, as a man, was told I could never be a father. Now, combine the two of us trying to have children, you can imagine it's less than a shot in hell of having children, essentially, is what was said to us for years. But, oh, my God, I definitely, to what you're talking about with opioids, I think it could have an effect for sure. But, again, by the time it was time to have my son Jackson, I was, if Jackson's six, I was 8 years into my full sobriety by then, so.
Wow.
An emergency. I'd also argue emergency C-section didn't help matters either as far as.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh,
but
that
again,
is
blessing. Such a blessing, though, regardless.
Yes, and God chose you, like you said, and Brianna said, and Luke
yes,
is thinking that at this time in your life, you can handle your little baby, because not everybody can do what you are doing, and it's your choice also if you want to be an active father, you
Thank
know
you,
so also with the commissioners,
mm-hmm.
I lived in Orange Seminole County for quite a while,
okay.
And now I am in Orange County.
Oh, wow.
I had an issue,
mm-hmm.
and Commissioner Ortiz,
mm-hmm.
dynamite. I just went to him and he helped me from that to the finishing of it. Commissioner DeLarry,
Ortiz, what
yes.
I know him as well. He's very energetic and he's one of those that are out in
oh,
front of the people all the time. You're correct.
On.
Yeah, you're right. Very hands on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And Commissioner DeLarry,
mm-hmm.
Though I am living now in Orange County,
mm-hmm.
I had a meeting with him to promote my photography.
Mm.
And immediately he just called around, got me in contact with all the agencies that do that.
Amazing.
And it is beautifully blooming. So whether I, you know, he facilitated that, though I was not in his jurisdiction. So,
oh my God,
you know,
if you're a real leader,
yeah.
real leader, you should be like,
uh-huh.
I'll give you a case in point. In Altamont, I had a
uh-huh.
young girl from Lake Brantley contact me. She says, so I understand you're my mayor, and I really need some help. I want to do a toy donation this upcoming Christmas to raise money for other children that have cancer. First of all, my mind was just blown at a young lady even thinking for others like that, right? And instead of, you know, saying, hey, well, really, you know, your mayor is technically Patty Bates from Altamont Springs, who's an amazing mayor, by the way. You take it over because you want your job. If you're a real leader and you're worth your weight in salt as a leader, you really don't have borders to who you're going to help, especially during the COVID-19 mm-hmm. outbreak. I mean, good Lord, I went to every senior center you could possibly go to, whether it's in my jurisdiction, whether it's not, because people need help. People need to see real leadership. And I think that's awesome, especially when you get help from somebody who technically is not within your district or your jurisdiction, like you just alluded to earlier. But personally, I think you shouldn't even be involved in this stuff if you're not willing to be doing things like that. That should, you know, be part of the deal. And that's awesome you called in to say that, though. I'm sure they appreciate that. Thank you, ma'am, very much for calling in.
You're welcome, Mac. And have a good day, Mac.
Be blessed, ma'am. Thank
Brianna
you.
And Luz.
Thank you. All right. Wow. Wow.
We have, any text messages?
We do.
Earlier?
We have some text messages to go through. Eunice chimes in. She says, your passion is definitely resonates when you talk about being a father. It's almost brought me to tears. Thanks for sharing your story.
Thank you.
Danny out in Lake Mary. We'll get to him in a second. Rock and Rob has been chiming in basically the entire show.
Rockin' Robin.
He's been encouraging me to hit you with a chair.
Thank you, Rock and Robin.
Tell him it's not going to happen. So get the bail money together because I'm not going to hit this man with a chair. Danny from Lake Mary said, does Longwood even need a police force with you as the mayor? Can't you just show up to police calls? Kind of intimidating.
You know what? Hey. There's an idea there, right?
There's an idea. Are we going to do it? We don't know. But if we see him on the news, yeah, we'll know that. We'll know where you got that idea from. Danny. Chet says, Karen also chimes in. She said, just popped in. Want to say I'm listening. Great show. Great host. Chet says, I'm listening from the FedEx truck. Was wondering what inspired you to get into politics? Two-part question. And is politics harder than the politics of wrestling?
No. I'll tell you, it's not hard in the politics of wrestling. Want to know why? Because in wrestling, you're on the road, and you're even sharing rental vehicles, if you will, sharing, you know, and the same playing with these other talents that you're in the ring with, where you give your body up to them in that ring, and you trust them not to injure you, not to hurt you, not to take food off the, you know, table, food off your family's table, if you will, by you getting injured. And by the same token, they're the first to stab you in the back. The minute you leave, they'll be in the, you know, Vince McMahon's ear at the time saying, oh, this Matt Morgan guy's a little unsafe. I'm a little nervous. You know, things like little things like that. There's a lot of backstabbing going on in wrestling for sure. It is a very cutthroat industry. There is no question. It's gotten a little bit better today, but when I was there, no, it was very cutthroat. And again, it definitely prepared me for this because, look, in politics, you do know who your enemy is.
Yeah.
I absolutely do. I could tell immediately. You don't have to be mean to him, obviously. I believe you should always be civil with one another.
Of course.
But by the same token, it's out there. You know who your opponent is, and it's game on.
Yeah.
Whoever your opponent is, it is game on, and I do not stop until I win. This is how it works.
I love it.
And I will outwork anybody and everybody. Are we wrapping up? Yeah. Okay. We're going to commercial break here, folks. You're listening to Florida Man Radio Network. This is The Blueprint. Matt Morgan, the most genetically jacked, athletically stacked, giant in pro wrestling history. That's right. Here on 660 AM / 105.5 FM, Florida Man Radio. Get the app. Do it all. We'll be back for break here in a few minutes. Thank you for listening.
You're listening to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark. Florida Man Radio.
Previously on the Bubba the Love Sponge Show.
With social distancing steps in place, he wants to go a step further. He's installing a thermal imaging camera.
That's ridiculous. I wouldn't go through that, would you?
If it was a restaurant that I already went to, I mean, if Forbici made me do that, I'd go through it. There's certain places where I would have no issue
with it. What happens if they tell you you're hot and they won't let you go in there?
Then I'm going to start throwing up because I'm going to think that I'm dying. So I'm
Bubba the Love Sponge, morning 6 till 10 on Florida Man Radio.
If you have legal papers to be served anywhere in the state, then the team at Magic Process, with more than 25 years in the business, is your go-to. Hey, it's Shannon Burke, and Magic Process is a full-service litigation support company offering not only service of civil process, but skip tracing, court filings, document recovery, public records researches, foreclosure sales, and eviction support. Get a discount if you tell them you heard it here on Florida Man Radio. Magic Process, Florida's premier process service and litigation support team, veteran-owned and operated. Call 407-541-0697 or online at magicprocess.com.
I'm Dr. Amar Habib with Advent Health. Balancing taking care of yourself and others hasn't been easy lately, but it's okay to take care of you. We want you to know we're ready when you're ready. We're taking every precaution, social distancing, wearing masks, checking staff and patient temperatures daily, and quarantining patients when we need to, so you can put your health first and feel safe in our care. Let's start healing. Learn more at AdventHealth.com.
Where can you find the most extensive and unique selection of President Trump re-election merchandise? At the Trump Store, right on Orange Blossom Trail in Apopka.
Believe me.
Hats, t-shirts, buttons, bobbleheads, socks, flags, over 200 President Trump items.
Terrific.
Masks, bandanas, and scarves for your protection. Get the real Trump merchandise at the Trump Store. A portion of each sale goes to the campaign. Visit the Trump Store today.
Truly, truly amazing. Amazing.
Look for the big tent and giant Trump letters at 1414 South Orange Blossom Trail in Apopka, between Shoots Straight and Sam's Club.
Don't go without working out. Southeastern Fitness Equipment and South Downtown can provide you with top-of-the-line home gyms, treadmills, ellipticals, spin bikes, and more. Buy the best brands in the industry like Cybex, Water Roller, and Life Fitness. Southeastern Fitness Equipment has over 20 years of fitness experience and wants to keep you working out. Curbside pickup available. Go to southeastfit.com and browse the catalog or stop into their showroom located in the Target Plaza on Orange Avenue in South Downtown.
Chill. Florida Man Radio.
Tune in to Push Talk Live with Silk and Biggs each and every Saturday from 10 to 11 a.m. for insight and laughs as they discuss news, entertainment, economic and financial gain, politics, music, and whatever they feel like that day. Tune in and join the conversation.
Adam and Eve is not giving you 10% off and not 20% off or even 40%. Your discount is even bigger. AdamandEve.com is giving you a whopping 50% off. But why stop there? In addition to 50% off, you also get 10 free gifts. That includes a racy item for him, a sensuous toy for her, and something we know you'll both enjoy.
Ooh.
And 6 extra special bonus items that are sure to rev your engine, pique your curiosity,
ooh,
and even blow you away. And best of all, free shipping, always delivered in discreet packaging. So rethink your bedroom routine. Go to adamandeve.com and enter the station's exclusive code at checkout, FLMAN, and get, you know the discount, 50% off almost any item and 10 tantalizing free gifts. That's FLMAN, FLMAN.
Hey, what you doing?
I'm checking my credit score on an app, but I had no idea my credit score was so low. What am I going to do?
Don't worry. Trade Guardian offers credit repair and credit counseling. Their monthly coaching program allows you to get your updated credit report every month. You can start seeing results in as soon as 30 days.
Wow, but that sounds like that's going to be expensive.
Not at all. Trade Guardian offers a free credit assessment to evaluate your options.
That sounds great. How do I get started?
Claim your free credit assessment from Trade Guardian today to start building the credit that you deserve. Find out more at mytradeguardian.com. That's mytradeguardian.com.
Bubba the Love Sponge.
Hey, it's Bubba the Love Sponge. Listen every weekday mornings right here on Florida Man Radio, powered by Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Florida Man is everywhere.
Everywhere.
Everywhere. In the car, on your radio at 660 AM and 105.5 FM. In the office or working from home, we're streaming live at floridamanradio.com. Out and about, on a run, listen live on the free Florida Man Radio app and on your Alexa device by saying play 105.5 Florida Man Radio. There's no reason to miss any of your favorites, like the Bump of the Love Sponge show.
One thing that brings my life down to zero.
The show?
No, this picture.
Damn.
Oh, shut up. That's not you.
Oh, look, yep. There's a tattoo. My Tyler tattoo.
Jacked up.
Man, Hogan's in the back doing abs.
Can you take off your shirt now and we do a side-by-side of this?
You have Power Radio with Justin Clark, the Ed Till Show, or the Shannon Burke Show.
Dumbass. We know we were off the air, dumbass. We have people that listen online, but you wouldn't know what that means because you're 90 years old.
Florida Man Radio. Unfiltered, unafraid, get it how you need to. Now, everywhere. Now, back to You Have Power Radio with attorney Justin Clark.
No, incorrect. Incorrect. Not Justin Clark, folks. This is the blueprint, Matt Morgan. The blueprint of the perfect athlete, and now the blueprint of, well,
the perfect radio host.
There we go. The perfect radio show. Yeah, radio show host here at Florida Man Radio. I have Power Radio, 660 AM / 105.5 FM. Again, floridamanradio.com. Get the app, Florida Man Radio app. Listen along that way as well. Take us with you. Call or text 321-339-1055. As we start to wrap up here, I saw we get a lot of questions about COVID-19.
Mm-hmm.
So how did the city of Longwood, what did you do differently or similar against COVID-19 pertaining to city of Longwood? Well, again, there is no I, there's a we in the city of Longwood. Very proud of that. I believe every leader knows how to engage others and make them part of the process and leadership as well. Some leaders lead from the front, some lead from the middle, some can even lead from behind. I think it depends on who is with you, who your staff is, and what their motivations are. And as a good leader, it's your job to determine what those are and set people up for the best success. So with that said, we're a team in Longwood. All of us commissioners, our city staff, everyone. So with that said, with COVID-19, I'm very proud of the fact that we were the first city in Seminole County to issue a state of emergency. We were the first city in Seminole County to start instilling social distancing in our commission meetings before social distancing was even a hashtag.
Hey.
Sincerely, like, it was at the time, if you guys remember, when they were saying no bigger groups than a 50 at the time.
Mm-hmm.
And then you remember, like, a day later, it dropped to 10. Well, when we were still in the 50 boat, we at our commission meeting had it down to 10 already. Mm-hmm. More importantly, equally as important, I should say, we're also the first city in Seminole County to lock City Hall or lock our City Hall front doors, but still have a skeleton staff there.
Yeah.
If somebody did need services, they could just call the number on the front door and somebody would come out and help serve them. Also, as well as our police department's front doors. So we didn't want to cross-contaminate at the time when this was all brand new. The most important part of this, obviously, is the ability to not wait around. A lot of times people will say, well, you don't want to be the first, and you also don't want to be the last. Mm-hmm. I will argue that is the quickest way to be mediocre and to finish second in life. Real leaders are not scared to put themselves out there and take the heat if you're wrong on something. If you shoot and miss, then, hey, that's on you. You need to own it. But again, I'd rather be the one to take the shot and I don't want to say take the chance, but take the calculated risk that what you're doing is correct. And it ended up being correct because other cities followed suit right afterwards. Mm-hmm. I mean, just days afterwards with how they went about their city closures, if you will. And then from there, it was on to, it moves up then, if you will, to then Seminole County mandating certain executive orders. That as a city mayor, I felt very proud to be a part of that decision-making process to some degree and having a legitimate seat at the table. Again, in Longwood, because you're the smallest city, a lot of times, you know, we don't get to just do that a city that, in my opinion, our city deserves. We've done a lot of great work in this city. Again, you heard me allude to earlier about Ryder Park.
Mm-hmm.
Like, just to put this in perspective, I was doing it. I think it was like a bio they were doing on me to get ready for the first, I would say, politician in Central Florida to appear on Fox and Friends. And again, before that happened, they were doing some bio on me. And I had a local guy doing it. And he's like, you know what, for the first time, he's looking around the park. He's like, Longwood has an identity.
Wow.
And I was like, we damn sure do. And it's called Strongwood. Strong moral values, strong family values, and strong as hell work ethic. This is a blue-collar city, and instead of roll their sleeves up and get to work. They don't wait for things to happen. They take it on in themselves and attack it aggressively with a strong work ethic. That is our city. And very, very proud of that, actually. And so, again, hashtag Strongwood for those of you listening at home.
Like it.
But very, 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 very proud of the work we've put into the city of Longwood. It's a completely different city. You know, like I said, we've added so many cool things to the city between Publix, LA Fitness, again, UPS expanding, getting so listen to this. UPS was across the country deciding on different places that they were going to add this expansion project to. All right. And I believe it was like $27 million. Right. And we were the only city in the state of Florida that won this bid that the UPS would agree to expand in that city. Every other place lost out to an out-of-state rival, UPS. And that says a lot about the city of Longwood, that that's where it's at now. That's the place to be. As crazy as that may sound to other people, look around. The city is lively. It's full of energy. You heard the caller say it earlier. He's 100% hitting the nail on the head with that. It is a different city, and one of the cool things that I'm very proud of, and I knew I'd bring to the table immediately, was the ability to get eyeballs on a small city like Longwood that it so richly deserved for years, the attention it deserved for years. Because again, I'm not I mean, let's just be honest. I'm not stupid. A lot of the time, these people are going to want to do interviews with me, and I get the national exposure for this city that it's never had before because of my background as a pro wrestler, obviously. So my job is to take that and parlay that into getting limelight for our city and the hard work of our residents of our city, our small business owners of our city, you know? And during the COVID outbreak, for instance, I was everywhere. And I have like a million followers on Instagram and Twitter combined. So I put that to use by going into different small restaurant, mom-and-pop-owned businesses during the COVID outbreak, letting everybody know where they can go get curbside pickup, where they can get delivery from. Please support your local mom-and-pop-owned businesses here in Longwood. Listen to me. Our small business owners got so inspired by this. We had an owner from Max and Mimi's. He'd been here for years, and he goes, "You're the first mayor to really come talk to me in person." And he goes, "I now know what a people's mayor is." Wow. He's from a foreign country, and he's telling me, "I heard about this American dream. I've been following the American dream, and now I know another American saying, which is called a people's mayor." That again, right there, that was my paycheck for the month. When he said that, I was that motivated me even more.
You gave him the blueprint for a people's mayor.
like seriously, that made my entire year.
Good.
You know, that kind of comment. It just lights you up. It makes you want to do more. Yeah. And so small business owners came together. We had one that owns a local mom and pop owned a marketplace in Longwood called Wild Hair. And she, you know, with not much of a pot to, you know, piss in, for lack of better terms, going through this struggle during this outbreak, not knowing if her business is going to be able to reopen. She's out there giving out free meals to kids that were going hungry during the outbreak because they couldn't get transportation over to Seminole County Public Schools, free meals they were given at the time. Here in Longwood, she was giving like over 500 she ended up giving out.
Jeez.
I was out there with her giving them away, and I was just looking at her going, "You're amazing. You really are amazing, ma'am." Her name is Cheryl Bryant. Love her to death. We have so many people in our city that stepped up during this. It's not just me. And I'm very, very honored by it. And before we wrap, I just want to say how also honored I am to be part of today's show. Taking over the blueprint, Matt Morgan. 7 feet tall, 330 pounds of the most genetically jacked, athletically stacked, elected official in Floridian history. There it is, folks. I said it. Therefore, it's true. Thanks for tuning in, and sorry about your damn luck, Justin.
Yeah, your show's been hijacked, friend.
Forever.
Ever.
That's right, yeah. I think I feel more protected from 7 foot than Justin.
Right, you know. Jeez, we're going to end up, like, get the blueprint in a pipsqueak.
You guys were awesome, by the way. Thank you so much.
We appreciate you coming in, taking over You Have Power Radio on the Florida Man Radio Network, and we will catch you all tomorrow.
But I've been in town for just now 15 years.